There's nothing much you can do about your skin generally. You know, what I generally do is to hydrate a lot of, I mean, I drink a lot of water, because at the end of the day, it's all in the internal detox or whatever it is that you want to do. But I think water is the best way to go, and keep your skin clean and do not have makeup on. Even if you're tired, make sure you clean it before you go to bed.
Face masks. A lot of moisturizing face masks. Not the sheet ones though, like the proper creamy ones.
Frankly, I try and take care of it throughout the year, so that when I'm approaching the fashion week, I don't feel the burden. But yes, before the fashion week and during the fashion week, we don't tend to sleep too much. So I make sure I drink a lot of water. I eat healthy, and that's the only way I can cope up with the beautiful stress that we go during fashion week.
How do you deal with the after effects of your skin?
I don't know what to do. It's tired. I think sleep and water, these two are the most important thing. I think if you sleep, you glow, and if you have enough water, you're fine. And stay away from junk just till the fashion week gets over, and then just eat whatever you want.
Lots of water, sleep, good food, fruits, and home food.
Yes, I go and do a face cleanup and hair spa. That's the best way to detoxify myself. I do sleep for 2-3 days more in a stretch and eat better, so that I recover all the vitamins that I've lost.
The beauty regime that you swear by?
I use alcohol-free products. I think they're very good for you. It doesn't strip off your skin moisture, which is natural. So try to stay away from alcohol-oriented makeup. Just stay away from all of that, because your natural moisture is very, very important.
Remove your makeup before you go to sleep, and moisturize your face if you have a dry face or dry skin. Yeah. Moisturizer.
Before, definitely wash my face, and I use Cetaphil moisturizer. I don't believe in brand, so that works for me beautifully. The more I take care of it, it backfires. And after the fashion week, yes, as I said, I go to the parlor and I get a face cleanup done.
3 hair care tips you follow after excessive hairstyling.
If you have product in your hair, make sure you wash it off. Never leave any product, whether it's mousse or hairspray or anything. After each and every fashion show, I make sure I keep my scalp clean. Secondly, try to wash your comb or your brushes very, very frequently. Dip it in alcohol water so that you disinfect whatever it is, residue on your comb or your brush. And third would be, I think you can just massage your head, your scalp, with your own fingers. I'm not a fan of oiling, but if you can just massage your scalp, it circulates the blood. So I think it's good for you, and you obviously can, you know, you get really good sleep. So you should try it with your own hands, of course. But if you have someone else doing it for you, it's even better.
3 hair care tips you follow after excessive hairstyling.
Oiling, deep conditioning, and that's it, I think. Oiling, deep conditioning, keep your hair clean.
3 hair care tips after excessive hair styling.
I go for a sustained hair treatment so that I can take the back combing and the tongs and the straightening that we go through. Yes, oiling my hair once in a week. And I'm going to be trying putting onion juice on my scalp, because I've heard it helps in growing. So that's something I'm still taking the courage to try and use it.
Hey, hello everyone. This is Dipti. Really cool channel. Subscribe, share, like, do whatever you feel like. Just log on to Be Beautiful and make us happy.
Okay. If you like this video, like, share and subscribe to Be Beautiful. Thank you.
Hey, this is Alessia Raut. I want you to like, share and subscribe to Be Beautiful, because if you want to know the trends, that's the page you need to follow.